Abraham Goff to be a false traitor.
By dissolve.
Tell me about my loyal subjects who harbored Goff for 20 years.
Rebels and traitors. They swear an oath of allegiance to Massachusetts rather than to you, Majesty.
Public duties.
Private pleasures.
Shaftesbury was taken from his bed at dawn and thrown into the Tower. High treason.
And Monmouth?
Forgiven again.
Who dares buy and sell my sovereign territory?
Men like John Hawkins of the Hawkins Bay Company. He buys the wilderness from Indians, parcels it up, and then rents it to settlers, or sells it on to land speculators like himself.
We have been distracted by our enemies in Parliament. But now they are overcome, it is time to remind Massachusetts. It is not a free state, but our colony. We granted its charter, and we can take it away. So, my Lord Jeffreys, if I grant your wife's brother the Fanshawe estates, he will expand his clay pits to make bricks for my new palace at Winchester.
He will, Your Majesty.
It will be the greatest honor, sire. I will move into Fanshawe House immediately.
You may have the land for your clay pits, but the house remains forfeit to me. However, if you were to bring me Abraham Goff.
As we speak, at the Rye House on the road from Newmarket to London as they return from the races.
How will it be done?
Six men will shoot down the lifeguard with blunderbusses. Another two will enter it and kill the king and his brother.